But today they are not here. They are not going to deal with them. We are not saved. They are better than them. Because the grace of God has a role to play in each and every one of us lives. So we thank God, they came, they saw, and they conquered. And hence, we are celebrating them today. As I talk about them, I also talk about those in JSS3. Because they are also graduating. Because we know that some of them, or few of them, may not return to Bosss to have their secondary school, their senior secondary school education. That's why we try to do something for them to feel that they have graduated too. But in them also, that class, in grace of hope, very competitive in that class, that sometimes I look up and look down, I say, God, please, allow all these kids to come back. Because today we make this school proud, and not this school giving their parents. I know what I'm saying. I monitor them very closely. The type of competition in that class is really amazing. So you give it up with your parents to help you to complement what we are doing here with the need. The sky will no longer be your limits, but your stepping stone. So we pray for you too as you enjoy your holidays, that God will guide you, protect you until you come back to continue with your senior secondary education. I would also appreciate our parents and guardians. Some of you may have received distress calls. Maybe in the time you don't even like it. You know how beautiful this room is from going to this place. But you must come because it's a responsibility. Either for health issues, maybe for visa, or sometimes for disciplinary measure. You are called upon, see what your child has done. Please, Father, please, can anything be done? Say no, madam or sir, you have to come. It's not too easy, but you've done all this because the faith you have in us, you have kept that faith. And for the good of these children, you did not relent. Some of you have sacrificed a lot, as we remind them daily. Be good for your parents. The efforts they are making, they are unquantifiable. So that because you are the investment, and I bet you, I promise you, dear parents, that your kids will not let you down. We pray for them, give them the best, as you are doing already. And at the end, you will reap the fruit of your labor. In Jesus' name. Now, going back to our eminent class of 2022, you must know that at any rate, one chapter in your life story comes to an end, and a new one will soon begin. As I say, the future, you don't know where the future is leading you, but always believe in that man that holds your future. As Nigerians, even in this time of economic meltdown and insecurity, with its attendant uncertainties, occasioned by bad governance everywhere in the country, but with the help of your parents and guidance, you have many opportunities to develop your talents. Some of you have already started here, and you have been raised with a great sense of generosity, service, and fairness that remind you every day. Be generous to one another, givers never lack. Also, availability to your neighbor, to your brother, to your sister, and fairness in whatever you do. These things will help you to go beyond your imagination. It's very exciting around to see our world using Nigeria as a case study that people don't even have any regard for life. The sanctity of life does not matter again. Do we join them or do we have to change the narrative? You are the future and lies around you. You must change our narrative. That is not to deny the fact that there are difficulties we find in our past activities and mindsets that sometimes we expect to go, and there are false pathways that seem to lead to happiness and fulfillment, but in fact end only in confusion and fear. Very, very important. The relationships you build, the boundaries you set. This is a global village. It's a world that advances. What you do now, I have a living room of the mind. You have to be very, very careful in whatever you do, because the whole world, they are really watching you. So you think temporarily, this is leading to happiness. But at the end of the day, you may see yourself going down. It's not a prayer for you. We know that God will always be by your side to lead you. But in 6 years of Catholic secondary school here in Bishop Okoye, behind him already, our prayer is that this year it has helped, shaped, and formed you so that you will be Boss, being a committed person to walk in the Lord's footsteps. Even when your path takes you through turns and twists, through the joys and prayers of ordinary life, may the Holy Spirit of God strengthen and guide you along the way. Your own life instead become a journey of hope. Don't expect that everything will be going normal. Once you think there now, that freedom you've been looking for will be open to you. But not freedom without responsibility. You must be careful about that. The goal of Catholic education and what makes Catholic education good news is the development of the whole person and the possibilities in general formation, which aims to prepare our students for life, both this life and the life to come. We are convinced that all human values find their fulfillment and unity in Christ. That's why whatever you do, look up to Christ. A Catholic education shall receive the foundation, not only intellectual knowledge. We try to expand their variety, both psychological, both physical, everything that can help you. Because in advanced countries like Europe and America, it's not all about their certificates, but what can you do? What can you produce? What you can bring to bear, which I thought that you've already been equipped with. With that, God will definitely be with you. It is in Christ that the fullness of truth concerning man is to be found. You have received an education of parents from having values. An education that presents the worldview that God matters. And now because God matters, so does the work of his hands, especially that work made in his own image and likeness, the human person. You must be very, very careful, the human person. Because we are all made in his likeness, we are all made in his image, we must protect life in whatever level we find ourselves. A certain Catholic education is not just meant to prepare you to make a good living. Note that very well. To do well in your life. A Catholic education is to help you learn the ways of being good and living well. Being good. Being all things to all men. Once you are good to people will love you. Celebrate you. When cases you presented, you may not be there. Others will be there to defend you or to condemn you. Wherever you find yourself, make sure you build a strong and good relationship with those around you. Our lives are gifts from God. But in a real way, our lives are like tasks entrusted to us by God. God has given you this year life, and that life has a purpose, whether you like it or not. And that's why you don't have any right to take your life. So you must be very, very careful about that. We acknowledge the beliefs of God's providence, but at the same time, we must recognize that our lives will be in a greater nature, what we make of them. So the whole is around you, your thoughts, the way you play it. We have already given you a platform for the management is good and your parents. It's now up to you to say, I want to be great, or I want to be the other way in the other side. My dear students, let us leave God with good memories. We may have had misunderstandings, challenges, and so many other things in the course of your formation. Remember that the trials and challenges of this life, they are not meant to make us bitter, but to make us better human beings. The aggregate of everything is what we are seeing now. I don't think there's any parent who will be happy to be forgiven his or her child. But the Bible tells us to spare the rod and spoil the child. In your formation days, you have encountered people time, maybe been insulted or flawed, whatever it may be. Of course, because of your misdeeds, it's an opportunity for you to reconcile with all those staff, members of the management, maybe your fellow students, before you leave here, so that you will leave here with a clean slate, with the fond memories of Bishop Godwin around you. Also, you must be good ambassadors of us and of your different families. We receive success stories, as you already know. Very soon, we'll be talking about some of you, or many of you, as we've done in the past, using you as a role model for others. But everything depends on you, the way you carry yourself along. Life is eternal, but at the same time, we must apply ourselves if we are to reach eternity. My dear students, who you are tomorrow depends much on how you are today, or how you live today. Very, very important. Plan for tomorrow, then be careful the way you live at the present. Because whether you like it or not, that is what will justify or make a good way for you. For the rest of the students, the younger ones, at least as they're living now, what will be the similar in those days? All those years, every year will have been ordained, and then it is reminding you that one day I will also be ordained. Those days too, you are looking forward, so that once they leave, then you will not be necessary. And if they don't go, you will not be promoted, whether you like it or not. So it is good they leave, even though with mixed feelings, feelings of joy, feelings of pain, because parting, most often, is not always the best. But however, today's ceremony becomes a booster for you that one day you will graduate and leave us as well. For what you are now, the ending class was, and what they are now, you will be by His grace. You will be like them tomorrow by the grace of God. Always remember that hard work rewards as help of their those who help themselves. Finally, don't forget that success has many friends. Why failure is an offer. You know all this. When you go for tournaments, if you win, you have so many friends who to rejoice with you. But if you don't win, what happens? people abandon you. You are now on your own. You are alone. That's what it is. So always walk out and pray to God. God will always be there for you. God will always be there for you. Have hope with God. Does not fall so cheap. You must make some sacrifices to achieve that. So as we celebrate it today, we pray that God, most of that is the work in you, we bring you to the happy end. Happy graduation, dear students, and may God bless you all. Peace be with you.
My dear sisters and brothers, let us pray. My dear sisters and brothers, let us thank God for the gift of our students who are graduating today, for the gift of our school mission today, for the gift of our parents, and for the gift of our children today. Those who are listening to the Lord should be excited.
Thank you.
pure sacrifice that you offer to the Lord. Therefore, Lord, we want to honor you by the same spirit. It's gracious with the holy spirit. We are brought to you for consecration. That they will become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this mystery. For the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which is given up.
Against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
He only takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord.
On the reception of the Holy Communion, only practicing Catholics